Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Let's start with the construction of the upper windchest. Now I'm preparing the mahogany sides with separators. I finished drilling and countersinking the soundboard. I proceed with the grooves, traced first with a router and then finished by hand. These are used to prevent air from passing from one hole to another, creating annoying noise. I glue the soundboard to a windchest. Now I mark the sliders and drill them corresponding to the holes on the soundboard. Once the sliders have been drilled, I establish rail travel by inserting a brass pin. Now I glue the sliders guides to hold the sliders in place and space the top board. In fact, they are slightly thicker than the sliders. Now you can see how it works. When you pull the slider, the stop is open. I sprinkle the sliders with graphite powder for better smoothness. Perfect. Now I'm making the pellet box. These holes are the ones that will fit the 6-foot regal register. Yes, in fact I managed to fit it. And it will be accessible in front of the organ to be able to be tuned on the fly and comfortably. So the organ will have 4 stops. The holes for the springs. Some reinforcements. I insert the various pins for the pallets. Here are the paper tubes that will carry the air from the windchest channels to the regal stop, being installed under the windchest. I close the windchest with a little hot high glue for easy maintenance. And I garnish it with leather to make it airtight. Here is the windchest installed. I open the pellet box. Here again are the tubes that carry air to the regal. Now I will have to insert the pallets, which I already done, with the relative springs. The linking of the keys to the pallets will pass from here. Here I will install the top board, which will be 3 cm thick, to accommodate the transports that will bring the wind to the pipes. Bye and see you next time.